And we're ready to go.
Always successful.
Thank you, Libby.
No, you're
entire will. I have a roll of toilet paper.
away. Yeah.
Are you finished? Hey, stop playing with your chips, will you?
I wasn't playing with them. I was looking at them. I was counting them.
I can't stand a guy who's winning and plays with his chips.
My house, Vinnie. If you want to play with your chips, you play with them, darling.
Hey.
I'm in for a quarter.
Aren't you going to look at your cards?
Yeah, well, Paul's going to bluff anyway. Who gets a coat?
I'll take your coat.
My friend Murray, the policeman, gets a warm coat.
You still fix that refrigerator? It's been 2 weeks now. No wonder it stinks in here.
Yeah, temper, temper. I wanted nagging. I go back with my wife. I'm out. Who wants food?
What do you got?
Brown sandwiches and green sandwiches.
What's the green?
That's a very new cheese, a very old meat.
I'll take the brown.
Are you crazy? You're not going to eat that, are you?
I'm hungry.
The refrigerator had been broken for 2 weeks. There was milk standing in it. It wasn't out of the bottle.
Brian! Some kind of help cut? Eat, Murray, eat.
I have six cards.
That figures. I have three aces. Miss Gill.
You guys
don't
make a really good sandwich. Felix, you ever taste cream cheese and pimento on date, not bread? Oh, it's really good.
Yeah, and then you...
All right, ladies, poker or recipe? Oscar, come on.
Hey!
Hey, Vinnie, tell Oscar what time you're leaving.
12 o'clock.
You hear that? We have 10 minutes till the next announcement. And a bullet for the policeman. Now this game is a 5-card draw. Murray, do something. Murray, it's up to you.
Hey, don't yell at my friend Murray.
I'm in the
beautiful, baby, beautiful.
Hey, Oscar, let's make a rule. Every 6 months, you buy a new bag of potato chips. How the hell can you live like this? Don't you have a maid or something?
Yeah, but she quit after my wife and kids left. The work got to be too much for us. Hey, the pot guy, who didn't win the quarter?
You did.
Got a big mouth, man. That's only $20.
I just loaned you $20. Or somebody else, I'll keep one of my own money back.
You know everybody's game. If you don't have it, don't play.
Damn it, I'm through being nice one here. You always 6 bucks a piece for the buffet.
What?
Buffet? Warm beer and two old sandwiches left over from when you went to high school?
What do you want at a poker game? A fatal surprise? Murray, let me $20 or I'll call your wife and tell her you're in Central Park wearing a dress.
No, you won't. There, maybe that's Felix. Ask him for money.
Pair of sixes. Why didn't you go to Florida last?
Ooh, Oscar the poker player.
Damn, it's my wife. Tell her I'm leaving by 12 o'clock.
You look at that watch one more time, you'll get a stale banana in the ear.
Who? What do you want, please? Dabby? Dabby who? No, no, no Dabby here. No, Daddy! Daddy, yeah, for Christ's sake, it's my kid! Yeah, but you see how it is, sweetheart? Yes, it's
fine. Wait, wait, come on.
Yeah, I finally got your letter. It took 3 weeks. Yeah, I know, but next time tell Mommy to give you a stamp. I know, sweetheart, but you're not supposed to draw it on. You guys hear this?
Yeah, we hear. We're all thrilled.
What was that, sweetheart? What goldfish? Oh, in your room! Sure, I'm taking good care of him. I killed my kid's goldfish! Crying out loud. Mommy wants to speak with me? Right, okay.
Hey, Oscar. Cost a dollar to play. You got a dollar?
Not to get through talking to this lady. Yeah. Hello, Blanche. Yeah, how are you? Yeah, I got a pretty good idea why you're calling. I'm a week now with the check, right? 4 weeks is not possible. Because it's not possible, Blanche. I keep a record of every check right here in my files. I happen to know I'm only 3 weeks behind. Don't you threaten me with jail, Blanche, because it's not a threat. With my expenses and my alimony, a prisoner takes home more pay than I do. Go, very nice language in front of the children. All right. $800 behind the alimony. Let's up the stakes.
She can do it, you know.
What?
Put her in jail for now before the kids.
Never. She can't call me once a week to aggravate if she's not happy.
Yeah, don't you worry about the kids.
Murr, the kids are living in the grandfather's house in California with a swimming pool. Can we just play cards?
What's the point? You shouldn't be in this kind of trouble. You probably don't know how to manage anything. I should know I'm your accountant.
You're my accountant. How come I need money?
If you need money, how can you play poker?
Because I need the money.
You always lose.
Well, that's why I need the money.
Don't play poker.
Well, don't come to my house and eat my pigeon chips, you see? Why die of pigeon chips? Put over here in my house. I don't need anything else in my house. You want to die of my pigeon chips? I can't.
All right, sit down.
I'm a cop. I guess it's all out of the game.
You just play poker for months.
Yeah, my friend Murray the cop is right. Can we just play cards? Please hold them up. I can't see where I'm marching.
You don't take anything seriously, do you? You don't mind the government, your wife, your friends.
What do you want me to do, Roy? Jump into the garbage disposal and grind myself to death? Life goes on, even for those of us who are divorced from the sloppy. Hello, divorce broken sloppy. Well, hello, sweetheart. Yes, yeah, baby, yes. Yeah. Well, I told you not to call me during the game. I can't talk to you now.
Stop, you little girl.
Okay, just a minute. Murray, it's your wife!
It's not a girl.
Yeah, that's right. I wish you were out in fair with her, then she wouldn't bother me over. Well, Mimi, what's wrong?
I don't know, you're coming home!
I don't know about 12:30.
I don't know about 12:30.
What?
Why? Corned beef sandwich and strawberry malt?
Is she pregnant again?
No, just that.
Oh, how did you hear that? I had the phone over there. I'm sorry. Yeah. I know. Oops. Felix? No, he didn't show that. Why? You're kidding. No, I had no idea.
In his wallet, and then something happens to him, America lights up.
When's he mugged?
Mugged for 36 hours? How much money could he possibly have on him?
I don't know. Maybe they took his clothes. I know a guy got mugged in a doctor's office once. Can't go home in a nurse's uniform.
Murray, you're a cop. What do you think?
I get something real bad.
How do you know?
I can feel my bones. You know, once you've been a cop for 25 years, you know all about bones. I've got bones you don't even know about.
Cut him off. He's drunk.
Maybe he's drunk.
Does Felix
drink?
Felix? On New Year's Eve, he drinks Pepto-Bismol. What are we catching at him? Paul's wife.
Now, wait a minute. Just because we don't know where he is doesn't mean somebody else doesn't. Does he have a girl?
A what?
You know, a girl. Like when you're through work early.
Felix, a girl? Are you crazy? He wears a vest and galoshes.
So, you automatically know who has and hasn't got a girl?
Yes, I automatically know.
If you're so smart, do I have a girl?
No, you haven't got a girl. You've got what I've got. What you wish you got and what you've got is a completely different civilization. Oscar maybe has a girl on his side.
Yeah, but he's divorced. It's not the side, it's more the middle.
The brew? One of our poker players is missing. I'd like to find out about him.
Yeah, I thought he was through the last couple weeks. Didn't you think he was a little edgy?
As a matter of fact, no. I thought you looked edgy.
Yeah, hello, Francis. Oscar, I just heard.
Oh, tell not to worry. It's probably hysterical. Right?
Yeah, you know, wait a minute.
Yeah. Most important thing is not to worry, Francis. Not worried.
Sure.
Hey, Francis, do you have any idea where it could be? You what? You're kidding. No. Why? I didn't know. It's too bad. Well, you just sit tight, Francis, okay? And the minute I hear something, I'll let you know. Bye.
through our detective.
They broke up.
Who?
Felix and Francis, who they broke up. The entire marriage just broke.
What happened?
I don't believe it.
She wants out, that's all.
After 12 years?
You're such a happy couple.
12 years doesn't mean you're a happy couple. It means you're a long couple.
Go figure. Felix and Francis.
What are you surprised at? He used to sit there every Friday night and tell us how to him we're fighting.
But who believes Felix?
I go to pieces. I know Felix. He'll try something crazy.
God, that's all he ever used to do. Sit there and talk about how his wife was wonderful and beautiful. What happened?
His wonderful and beautiful wife can't stand him.
That's what happened. He'll kill himself. You know what I'm saying? He's going to go out and try to kill himself.
Murray, will you shut up? Stop being a cop for 2 minutes. Oscar, where'd he go?
See what I tell you?
You're kidding.
Well, she said he was going out to kill himself. He didn't want to do it at home because the kids were sleeping.
Why?
Why? Because Felix did enough, that's why.
That's right. Remember he tried something like that? He would break off the engagement and start washing guns in his mouth.
Yeah, but Felix is talk. That's all he ever does is talk.
But is that what he said, Oscar? In those words, I'm going to kill myself.
Don't know in what words, Vinnie. She didn't read it to me.
And he left a note?
No, he sent a telegram.
A suicide telegram? Who sends a suicide telegram?
Felix the nut, that's who. Can you imagine getting a thing like that? She didn't have to tip to get a dollar.
I don't get it. What's the kill him after the telegram?
See how his mind works? He sends a note, she might not get it till Monday. And then he'd have no excuse for not being dead. This way, for $1.10, he has a chance to be safe.
See, he really don't want to kill himself. He just wants to sit.
What he'd really love is to go to the funeral. He'd sit in the back, he'd be the biggest crier there.
Yeah, he's right.
Of course I'm right.
We get these cases every day. All they ever want is attention. You know, we got a guy that calls us every Saturday afternoon from George Washington Bridge.
Oh, no. You never tell a guy who's hysterical.
Nah, 9 out of 10 times they don't jump.
What about the 10th time?
They jump?
He's right. There's a possibility.
How would Felix? I know him. He's too nervous to kill himself. He wears a seatbelt to the drive-in movie.
Someplace
we can
look for him.
Where? Where would we look for him? Who knows where he is?
Of course. If you're gonna kill yourself, where's the safest place to do it? With your friends, right? Vinnie, open the door.
Wait a minute. Maybe it's Sarah. Let's play nice and easy. If we're calm, maybe he'll be calm.
That's right. That's what they do with those guys on the left. Talk to nice and soft.
Right. What do we say?
We don't say nothing. Like, we never heard a thing.
Oh.
Get through with this discussion, because he could already hung himself out in the hall. Vinnie, open the door!
How's the game going?
Good.
Good. Sorry I'm late.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Don't you have any Coke?
I don't think so. I got
7 up. No, I felt like a Coke. I just don't feel like 7 up tonight.
And what's the bet?
It's a quarter. It's up to Murray, it's up to you.
Tap your shoulder.
What?
Murray, it's up to you. Are you in or out?
Why is it always up to me?
It's not always up to you, but it's up to you now. What are you going to do?
Did anyone call about me?
Call? Not that I can remember. Did anyone call for Felix?
No.
Were you expecting a call?
No. Just asking.
See you in a bit and raise a dollar.
I just thought someone might have called.
That's a dollar and a quarter, right?
Right.
But if no one called,
What is it again?
A dollar and a quarter. Will you pay attention for Christ's sakes?
All right, take it easy. Take it easy, guys.
I can't help it. He makes me nervous.
I make you nervous? You make me nervous. You make us all nervous.
Well, I'm sorry. Forgive me. I'll just go kill myself.
Murray!
Sure, it's a pretty view from here.
What is it? 12 floors?
No! No, it's not 12 floors! It's just 11. That's all. It says 12, but it's really just 11. Chilly in here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Listen, Felix, it's still early. You want to sit down and play a couple games?
Sure, Felix. We'll be here till 3-4 in the morning.
I don't know. I just don't feel much like playing now.
Well, who do you feel like doing?
I'll find something. Don't worry about me.
Hey, where are you going?
To the job.
Hello?
I always feel alone. Why?
No reason. You're going to be in that line?
As long as it takes.
Are you crazy? Let him go down alone? What if he tries to kill himself?
How's he going to kill himself in the John?
With pills, razor blades, whatever's in there.
It's the kid's bathroom. The worst he can do is brush his teeth to death.
Ain't that window there?
Yeah, it's only 6 inches wide.
Yeah, but you break glass in the gutter.
Yeah, he can also flush himself into the East River. I'm telling you, he's not going to try anything.
There's a guy. That's terrible.
For God's sakes, Oscar, do something. Say something.
What? What do you say to a man who's crying in your bathroom?
I guess I'll be running along.
Felix, wait a minute!
No, I can't talk to you! I can't talk to anyone!
Listen now, talk to me!
There's nothing to say! There's nothing to talk about!
Let him go!
Let me go!
Okay,
let him out.
It's okay.
Something's
great! Felix! Don't let him in the bathroom!
No! Let me out of here!
You're
horrible! Leave me alone! Why don't you leave me alone?
Felix, run it out! I warn you!
Leave me alone! Please, just leave me alone! It's my problem! I'll settle on my own. My stomach.
Hey, what's wrong with your
stomach?
He looks sick. I'm sick. I didn't take anything, I swear.
What do you mean you didn't take anything?
Nothing. I didn't take anything.
What?
Don't you call Francis.
He took something.
Felix, what? What?
Nothing. I didn't take anything.
Bill, did you take
anything? No, Oscar, no.
Thank God he didn't take anything.
Just get him a drink.
12 years. 12 years,
Vinnie. Did you know we were married 12 years, Roy?
Yeah, Felix, I do.
Now it's over. Just like that, it's over. That's hysterical, isn't it?
Cool. Maybe it's just a fight. You guys fight all the time.
No, it's over. She's getting a lawyer tomorrow. My cousin. She's using my cousin. Who am I gonna get?
Listen, I was seeing her looking at a clock.
Yeah, fellas, this song. Let's call it a night, okay?
All right. I'm sorry, fellas. I'm so ashamed. Please forgive me. Promise me you won't tell anyone about this, will you, then?
I won't tell anyone, Felix. I'm going to court in the morning.
Oh, gee, that's nice.
Thanks.
We were going to go to Florida next winter without the kids. No, I guess they'll go without me.
I think what I should say.
All right.
You sure?
Sure.
All right, well, yeah. What if you try something again?
Hey, he's not going to try anything.
How do you know he won't try anything again?
I won't try anything again. I'm very tired.
Yeah, he's tired. Had a busy night, okay? Good night, fellas.
Oh, good night.
Good night, Felix. Thanks, Austin.
Hey, Oscar, if anything happens, give me a call.
Remember, I live 3 blocks away. I can be here in 5 minutes.
If you need me, I'll be at the Ruehrmund Motel in Miami Beach.
Be the first person I call, then.
Hey, you sure?
I'm sure.
All right, well, hey, Felix, you know, try to get a good night's sleep. Things are going to look a lot brighter in the morning. Take away his belt and his shoelaces.
Ooh, Felix, 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 Felix.
I know. Oscar, what am I going to do?
We'll talk about it later. Let's get something to eat first. You like some nice hot Ovaltine?
The terrible thing is I still love her, Oscar. I've always loved her.
Hey, how about some vanilla wafers, Vienna fingers? How about some chocolate Malamars? I had everything you had.
We had so much together. Two beautiful kids, a beautiful home. Who ever had more beautiful kids or a more beautiful home?
Nobody, Felix, nobody.
12 years of marriage down the drain.
Drains can be fixed, that's why we have plumbers.
It's not fair, damn it! It's just not fair!
My neck.
What's wrong with your neck?
Nothing. It's a spasm. I get it in the neck. I get it from the tension.
I wouldn't be surprised. Hey, let me see where it
is. No, don't touch me, Arthur!
I don't
no,
want to see you!
No, right don't hurt. Touch me, Arthur!
Will you relax, Jay? Relax! Gee!
I can't help it, Oscar. Ow!
Yeah, does that hurt?
No, it feels good.
Well, then say so. You make the same sounds for pain or happiness.
I know, Oscar, I know. I can't help it. I think I'm crazy.
If you feel any better, I think so, too.
I mean it. Why else do I come here and go to pieces like that? Threatening to kill myself? What is that?
Panic, Felix. You're a panicky person. You have a low threshold for composure.
Don't stop. That felt good.
Listen, if you don't relax, I'm going to break my fingers. Look at this. The only man in the world with clenched hair. Okay, leave over.
I tell the whole world my problems.
Now, Felix, if this hurts, just tell me, because I don't know what the hell I'm doing.
Oh,
What's that sound? Hey, how's your neck feel?
Better.
Only my back hurts now.
What you need is a drink.
I can't drink, Oscar. I tried drinking last night.
Where were you last night?
Nowhere. I just walked.
All night?
All night.
In the rain?
No. In a hotel. I couldn't sleep, so I just walked around my room all night. Over near Times Square. Very depressing place. I found myself glancing out the window, and suddenly I started to think about jumping.
Changed your mind.
Nothing. I'm still thinking about it.
Yeah, drink this.
I don't want to get a divorce, Oscar. I don't want to suddenly change my whole life around. Talk to me, Oscar. What am I going to do?
Okay, well, first you're going to pull yourself together. And then secondly, you're going to drink that. And then you and I are going to sit down and figure out a whole new life for you.
Without Francis or the kids?
It's been done before.
You don't understand, Oscar. I'm nothing without them. I'm nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? You're something. You're a person. You're flesh and blood and bones and fish. No, you're not a fish. You're not a fish. And you're not a buffalo. And you're just you, Felix. You walk and talk, cry and complain, eat little green pills, and send suicide telegrams. Nobody does that, Felix. I'm telling you, you're the only one of its kind in the world. Here, I'll drink this.
What did you do, Oscar? You've been through it yourself. How'd you get through those first few nights?
Same thing you know.
Being hysterical?
Nope. Drinking. Drink for 4 days and 4 nights. Fell through a window. I was bleeding, but I was forgetting.
How can you forget your kid? How can you wipe out 12 years of marriage?
You can't, Felix. Every night when you walk home into this big 8-room apartment, it slaps you in the face like a wet glove. But those are the facts. You gotta face it. You can't spend the rest of your life crying. It annoys people in the movies. Now be a good boy and drink your scotch.
I can only imagine what Frances must be going through.
What do you mean what she's going through?
Oh, it's always harder on the woman, Oscar. She's all alone there in the house, stuck there with the kids. She can't get out like me. Besides, where is she going to meet someone now at her age?
I don't know. Maybe someone will come to the door. Felix, I'm telling you, there's 100,000 divorces a year. There has to be something nice about it. What are you doing?
My ears are closing up. I get it from my sinuses. It must be the dust in here. I'm allergic to dust.
Hey, where are you going? Where are you going?
I'm not trying to jump. I'm just trying to breathe. I used to drive Francis crazy with my allergies. I'm allergic to everything. I'm allergic to her perfume. For a while, the only thing she could wear was my aftershave lotion. That was impossible to live with. It's a wonder it took this long.
What's the matter?
I'm trying to clear out my ears. You feel the pressure from the inside and it opens it up.
Did it open up?
A little bit. I think I strained my throat.
Felix, why don't you leave yourself alone? Don't tinker.
I can't help it, Oscar. I drive everyone crazy. Marriage counselor once threw me out of his office and wrote on my chart lunatic.
It takes two to make a rotten marriage, bro.
You don't know what I was like at home. I bought her a book. I made her write down every penny we spent in it.
A
A dollar for cigarettes, 50 cents for paper. Everything had to go in the book. And then we had a big fight because I said she forgot to write down how much the book was.
Who could live with a person like that?
An accountant? Listen, Felix, I'm telling you, I don't know. We all have faults.
We had a maid. She came in 3 times a week to clean. And on the off days, Francis would clean. And then at night, after they'd cleaned the entire place, I'd go in and clean it all again. I can't help it. I just like things clean. That's the way I am. Actually, I blame it on my mother. I was toilet trained at 5 minutes late.
How do you remember things like that, Bill?
I lost up the entire marriage. The minute she would step out of that kitchen, I'd be in there adding salt and pepper. It's not that I didn't trust her. It's just... I'm a better cook. I cooked myself right out of marriage. Stupid damn thing!
Hey, Felix, don't do that. You'll give yourself a headache.
I can't help it. I hate me, Oscar. Oh, boy, do I hate me.
You don't hate you, Felix. You love you. You think no one has problems like you. Come on, Felix. I've never seen anyone so in love.
I thought you were my friend.
This is why I can talk to you this way, because I love you almost as much as you do.
Then help me.
How can I help you when I can't even help myself? Blanche used to say, what time do you want dinner? I'd say, I don't know, I'm not hungry. And then 3 o'clock in the morning, I'd wake her up and say, now! I've been one of the highest paid sports writers in the East for the past 14 years. I've saved $8.50. And pennies. I drink like a fish, I gamble, I burn cigar holes in the furniture, I lie to every chance I get. And then for our 10th wedding anniversary, I took her to see the New York Rangers Detroit Red Wings hockey game, where she got hit by a puck. I still can't figure out why she left me. That's how impossible I am.
I don't think I can take it alone, Oscar. How am I going to work? How am I going to make a living?
You go on street corners and cry, they'll throw nickels at you. Your work, Felix, your work.
You think I have a caller?
What for?
To talk it out again.
You've talked it all out. There are no words left in your entire marriage. When are you going to face up to it?
I know. I just don't know what to do, Oscar.
Then listen to me. Tonight you'll stay here, then tomorrow you're going to go over and get your clothes and you'll left your toothbrush and you'll move in with me.
No, it's your apartment. I'll just be in the way.
That is 8 big rooms. We can go for a year without seeing each other. Don't you understand? I want you to move in.
Why? I'm a pest.
No, you're a pest. You don't have to keep telling me.
Then why would you want me to move in?
Because I can't stand living alone. For crying out loud, Felix, I'm proposing to you. What do you want, a ring?
All right, Oscar. If you really mean it, there's a lot I can do around here. I'm very handy around the house. I can fix things.
You don't have to fix things.
I want to do something, Oscar. Let me do something.
Okay, you can take my wife's initials off the towels. Anything you say.
I'll cook. I'm a trick to cook.
You don't have to cook, Felix. I have enough potato chips in there to last me a year.
We'll save a fortune, Oscar. We have to pay up on alimony, you know.
All right, Felix, you can cook.
Do you like leg of lamb?
Yes, I like Lakers Lane.
Good, I'll make it tomorrow night. Although, I'll have to call Francis. She has all my big pots.
Will you forget Francis? We'll get our own pot. Don't drive me crazy before you move in. Hello? Oh, hello, Francis.
I'm not here. I'm not here. You don't know where I am. You haven't seen me. I didn't call. I'm not here, Oscar.
Yes, he's here.
How does she sound? Is she worried? I bet she's crying. What is she saying?
Yes, she is.
You can tell her. I've had it there. I'm through. I've made up my mind. And you can tell her for me that if she thinks I'm coming back, she has another thing coming. Tell her, Oscar. Tell her.
Yeah, she's fine.
I'm not fine. What did you tell her that for? You heard me carrying on before. I'm not fine.
Yes, I understand, Francis. I understand.
Does she want to talk to me? Ask her if she wants to talk to me.
Do you want to speak with him?
Give me his phone. I'll speak to her.
I don't want to speak with him.
She doesn't want to speak.
Yeah, I see, Francis.
But. She didn't want to speak to me.
Nope.
Well, why'd she call then?
She wants to know when you're coming over for your clothes. She wants to have the room painted.
Oh.
Listen, Felix, it's almost 1 o'clock, okay? Let's...
Didn't want to speak to me, huh?
Hey, Felix, I'll get you a pair of pajamas. I got stripes, dots, or animals.
Oh, she's really heartbroken, isn't she? I want to kill myself, and she's picking out colors.
Hey, Felix, what bedroom do you want? I'm lousy with bedroom.
You know, I'm glad. Because she finally made me realize it's over. I don't think it's sunk in until just this minute.
Felix, I want you to go to bed.
I don't think I believed her until just now that my marriage is really over.
Felix, go to bed.
Not now, Oscar. I have to think. I have to start rearranging my life. You're thinking this thing.
What are you talking about? Not now. This is my house, Felix. I make up the bedtime.
Oscar, please, I need to be alone. Go to bed. I'll clean.
Wait. No, you don't have to clean. I pay people to clean.
Oscar, please. I couldn't sleep with all this dirt around anyhow. I'll be all right. Go to bed. See you in the morning.
Not gonna do anything big, are you? Like vacuum in the ceiling?
10 minutes, that's all I'll be.
You sure?
I'm sure. I'm just gonna do the dishes and go to bed. Glass beer for Murray.
Thank you, Felix.
Where's your coaster?
Like Kings Island?
Your coaster. You know, the little round thing that goes underneath the glass.
Oh, that. I think I bet it.
I knew I was winning too much here.
Always try to use your coasters, fellas.
Scotch and a little bit of water.
Scotch and a little bit of water. And I have my coaster.
I hate to be a pest, but you know what my glasses do? They leave little rings on the table.
I don't want little rings on the table.
Your clean ashtray for Roy. And a nice warm sandwich for me.
Well, gee, that smells good. What is it?
Bacon, lettuce, and tomato with mayonnaise on pumpernickel toast.
Where'd you get it?
I made it in the kitchen.
You mean you cooked the bacon and you got the lettuce too for me?
If you don't like it, I'll make you a meatloaf. Meatloaf takes 5 minutes.
Wow. It's no trouble, honest. I love to cook. Eat over the dish, though. Just back in the corner. Oscar!
Yes, sir?
I forgot what it was that you wanted. What did you ask me for?
2 3½-minute eggs and some petty pours.
A double gin and tonic. I'll be right back. Who turned off the dehumidifier?
So what?
The dehumidifier. I told you not to play with this, fellas. I'm trying to get some of the grime out of the air.
Bert, maybe $200 for your time.
I can't take this anymore. In the past 4 hours, we've played 8 minutes of poker. I've had it up to here. I'm not giving up my Friday nights to watch cooking and housekeeping.
Can't breathe. That stupid machine is sucking everything out of the air.
This is so delicious. It's just perfect. Who wants a bite?
Is the toast warm?
I don't know how it could be better, and there's not much mayonnaise.
Well, cut me up a little piece. Well,
give me a napkin. I don't want so many crumbs.
Oh, right, yeah. That'd be better.
Do you hear this? Martha and Gertrude at the Automat. What the hell happened to our poker game?
Yeah. I'm telling you, I think you kills. You'll find us here in the morning with the tongues on the floor.
Please do something. Get him back in the game.
Don't bother me with Betty's little problems here. I'm cooped up. Mary Poppins, 24 hours a day.
It was Mary before with all smoke everywhere and the garbage all over the floor. It was Mary before.
Did you notice what he did with the bread?
No, what?
He cut off the crust.
I know.
That's why the sandwich is so light.
Right. Yeah. He only uses that, like, the soft green part.
Yeah.
Right, the soft green part. I'm going out of my mind.
Felix, hey, Felix.
I'm going home.
This beam's down.
I'll start to read again. I'll buy a book.
Sit, will you sit down?
The minute his marriage broke up, our poker game broke up. If you get some real players next week, please call me.
You can't run out now. I'm a big loser.
That's right, you're a big loser. It's your fault the game's busted. You stopped him from killing himself.
He's right. The man is absolutely right.
Are you going to eat that pickle?
I wasn't thinking of real blank. You want it?
Well, I mean, unless you want it. It is your pickle. I wouldn't want that.
Nah, I usually don't eat pickles. I want them, you know. There you go. Hey!
What are you there for? Oh, my God!
You're going to kill the pedestrian.
Just deal the cards, okay? You want to play all the deal the cards? You want to eat both of them down the street? Hey, Vinnie, please, keep your sandwiches and your pickles for yourself, okay? And we're going to leave tonight and jolly here, everybody's getting fat. Felix!
What the heck is going on?
Down, okay, we've got a poker game. skate blonde hair so that looks like you.
Last long way for the past 4 hours. Nature not intend to poke your play this way.
All right, we're ready to play.
Oh, good, we got just enough for handball.
Where's everybody?
Boy, you got the nerve to ask that question. I've just been sterilized out of $53.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Oscar. Is that my fault?
I guess not so much like playing, wasn't
it,
Felix?
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Something's happened to the old gang.
You know what's happened to the old gang? Break it up! Everybody's getting divorced. I swear, we just fed a game until we couldn't get out at night.
I guess I'm going to. Vinnie and I are driving to Asbury Park for the weekend.
Oh, that's nice. You two always do things like that together, don't you?
We have to. I don't know how to drive, Felix. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
All right.
Coming home by 2 with a frozen sandwich and corned beef and Claire salt and all punched out.
Yeah.
You two Blue Boys sure got the life, huh, man?
Yeah, some life in Blue Boys, Dad.
That's funny, isn't it, Oscar? They think we're happy. They really think we're enjoying this. But they don't know. They don't know what it's like.
Felix, I'd be immensely grateful to get any clean up here.
Oh, it's just a few things. You know, I can't get over what Murray just said. I really think they envy us.
Felix, can you just leave everything alone, okay? I'm not through dirtying up with a knife.
But don't you see the irony of it, Oscar? Don't you see it?
Yes, I see it.
No, you don't. I don't think you see it.
Felix, I'm telling you, I see the irony of it.
What is it, then? What's the irony? Tell me.
The irony is, unless we come to some other sort of arrangement, I'm going to kill you. That's the irony.
What are you talking about?
I just don't think two grown men living alone should have to clean the house of my mother.
I'm not asking you to do it, Oscar. You don't have to clean.
Yeah, but what you do is worse, though. You're always going in the bathroom, hanging out my towels when I smoke. You follow me around with an ashtray. Last night, I found you in that kitchen, on your knees, moaning and shaking your head and moaning footprints.
I didn't say they were yours.
Yeah, well, they were mine. Damn it, I have feet and they make prints. What do you want me to do, climb across the cabinets?
No, I want you to walk on the floor.
Oh, I appreciate that. I really do.
I'm sorry, Oscar. I didn't realize I irritated you that much. I'm just trying to make this place livable, that's all.
Leave my pictures alone.
I'm just trying to even them up, Oscar.
I want them uneven. They're my pictures. Why don't you even up your own pictures?
I was wondering how long this would take.
How long what would take?
Before I got on your nerves.
I didn't say you got on my nerves.
Well, you said I irritated you. It's the same thing.
No, you said you irritated me. I didn't say it.
Well, what did you say then, Oscar?
I don't know what I said. What's the difference what I said?
Oh, it doesn't matter. I was just repeating what I thought you said.
Well, don't repeat what you thought I said. Repeat what I said. My God, that's irritating.
You see, you did say it.
I don't believe this whole conversation.
I'm sorry, Oscar. I don't know what's wrong with me.
No pout, Felix. You want to fight? We'll fight. But no pouting. Fighting I win, pouting you win.
You're right. You're right. I do that. Everything you say is absolutely right.
Don't give in so easily. You're not always wrong. Sometimes you're right.
You're right. You're right. I always figure I'm in the wrong.
Only this time you're wrong and I'm right.
Oh, leave me alone.
And don't sulk. It's the same as pouting.
I know. Damn me, why can't I do one lousy thing right?
Why don't you throw it?
I always did. Sometimes I get so insane with myself.
And why did you throw the gun?
Because there'd be no point.
Well, why do you have to control yourself like that, Felix? You're angry, you felt like throwing the cup. Why didn't you throw it?
Because I'd still be angry and I'd have a broken cup.
But how do you know how you feel? Maybe you'd feel wonderful. Why do you always have to hold back? Why don't you let loose once in your life? Do something that you feel like doing, not what you think you're supposed to do. Come on, Felix. Stop keeping books. Get angry. Get drunk. Relax. Break the stupid cup.
Ow! My arm!
You're hopeless. You're a hopeless mental case.
What a stupid thing to do. I'm not supposed to throw with that arm.
Felix, why don't you live in a closet, huh? I'll leave your meals outside. I'll slip the slide papers underneath. Is that safe enough?
Do you have a heating pad? I used to have bursitis in this arm. Made me give up golf.
How can you hurt your arm throwing a cup? I mean, if it had coffee in it, that's one thing. But a broken cup or an empty cup?
All right, Oscar, that's enough. I get hurt easily. That's how I am.
Oh, you're not going to cry, are you? I think all those tears dripping down your arm is what gave you bursitis.
You know, I once got it just by combing my hair.
Got a world full of roommates. I had to pick myself the Tin Man.
You're darn right you could have done worse. A lot worse.
How?
Well, how'd you like to live with Ten Thumbs Murray or Speed in his complaint? Don't forget I cook and clean and make this house livable. And I save us a lot of money, don't I?
Yeah, but then you keep me up all night counting it.
Wait a minute. We're not always going at each other. We have some fun too, don't we?
Fun? Felix, getting a clear picture on Channel 2 is not my idea. Whoopee!
What are you talking about?
Okay, what do you and I do every night?
What do we do? You mean after dinner?
That's right. After dinner, after we've had your halibut steak, and the pans have been SOS'd, and the sink has been done, and the dishes are all clean, and the leftovers have been saran wrapped, what do we do then?
Well, we read. We talk.
No. I read and you talk. I try to work and you talk. I take a bath and you talk. I try to sleep and you talk. We got your life arranged pretty well, but I'm still looking for a little entertainment.
What are you saying, Oscar, that I talk too much?
No. I'm not complaining, Felix. You got a lot to say. What's worrying me is I'm beginning to listen to you.
Oscar, I told you 100 times just to tell me to shut up. I'm not a sensitive man.
I don't think you're getting my point, Felix. But a husky man, I've spent enough evenings deciding tomorrow's menu. Tonight was made for other things.
Like what?
Unless I get to touch something soft in the next 2 weeks, I'm in big trouble.
Oh, you mean women.
Right, if you want to give it a name, fine, women.
You know, that's funny. I haven't even thought about women in the last couple of weeks.
Bill, see the humor too.
No, really, that's very strange. I mean, when Francis and I were happy, there wasn't a girl on the street I didn't stare at for 10 minutes. I used to take the wrong subway home just following a pair of legs. But ever since we broke up, I don't even know what a woman looks like.
Well, I'd like to go downstairs and buy a couple of magazines, or I can make a phone call.
What are you saying, Oscar?
What I'm saying is, let's spend one evening talking to someone with higher voices than us.
You mean, like a date?
Yes.
Well, I couldn't.
Why not?
Because it's all right for you, Oscar, but I'm still married.
But you can cheat until the divorce comes through.
It's not that, Oscar. It's just I have no feeling for it. I can't explain it.
Try.
Listen,
Listen, Oscar, I intend to go out. I get lonely, too. But it's only been a few weeks now. Just give me a little time.
Time, Felix? There's no time left! I booked in TV Guide, there's nothing on this week. What am I asking you to do? Have drinks with a couple of girls, eat and talk? It's not hard, you've done it before, you need to talk, huh?
Can't you go by yourself? Why do you mean me?
Because I may want to come back here afterwards if I come home and find you washing the windows and puts a damper on things.
I'll take a pill and go to sleep.
Why take a pill when you can take a girl?
Because I feel guilty about it, that's why. Maybe you don't understand it, but that's the way I feel, Oscar.
All I care, you can take her in the kitchen and make a blueberry pie. But it's a lot healthier than sitting up every night in your bed and writing Francis's names all throughout the crossword puzzle. Felix, just for one night, talk to another girl.
Besides, who would I call? The only single girl I know is my secretary, and I don't think she's interested.
Well, then leave that to me. There's two single girls that live in this town. They live in this building. And one's a widow, the other's a divorcee. They're a barrel of laughs.
And how would you know?
I was trapped in the elevator with them last week. Anyway, I've been meaning to call, and I just didn't know which one to call. And they chilly for the Giants. So be perfect.
Well, what do they look like?
Don't worry, yours is very pretty.
I'm not worried. Which one's mine, Oscar?
The divorcee.
Why do I get the divorcee?
I don't care. You want the widow?
No, I don't want the widow. I don't even want the divorcee. I'm just doing this for you, Oscar.
Look, do it for whoever you want, okay? When they get to the door, point to the sister of your choice. I just want to get a couple laughs, okay? Say all right, this is important. I want you to try and have a good time. Say I promise.
I promise.
Again.
I promise.
And no writing in the book $1.30 for the cab.
No writing in the book.
Okay. No one is to be called Francis. It is Gwendolyn and Cecily.
No Francis.
Okay. No moaning, groaning, sighing, complaining, crying, talking.
I'll smile from 7 to 12.
Okay. And this, above all, Felix, no talk of the past. Only the present. The new Felix I've been waiting for. This is going to be some night. Good night, Felix.
$40.
What kind of double date is that? You'll be cooped up in the kitchen all night.
No, I won't, Oscar. Once I get my potatoes, then I'll have all the time in the world.
What happened to the new Felix? Who are you calling?
Francis. I'm gonna get a recipe for meatloaf. The girls will be crazy about it.
something wonderful is going wrong in that kitchen, let me tell you. Maybe. Listen, Felix, on the way home, I picked up the wine. I hope you don't mind. And it cost me 6 1/4. We'll have to walk for it this week. Listen, Bill, I think it's called a Ricotta. I think it's a French wine. French wine. Is that okay with you, Felix? French wine? Anyway, I got the wine. Hey, Felix, what's the matter? It's has to be something matter because I can tell by your conversation. Okay, Felix, what is it?
What is it, Oscar? Let's start with what time you think it is.
I don't know. 7:30?
7:30? Try 8 o'clock.
Okay, 8 o'clock, so?
So, you said you'd be home at 7.
Know what I said?
That's what you said. I'll be home at 7 is what you said.
Okay, so I said I'll be home at 7 is 8 o'clock, so what's the problem?
So, if you knew you were going to be late, why didn't you call me?
I couldn't call, Felix, I was busy.
Too busy to pick up a phone? Oh, come on, Oscar. Where were you?
I was in the office, working.
Working? Ha!
Yes, working.
I called your office at 7. You weren't there.
Okay. I spilled something on my pants, okay? The cab, you wouldn't let me in the cab. I couldn't get home. I had to walk.
Since when do they have cabs in Hannigan's bar?
Now listen, Felix, this is no time to have a domestic quarrel. We have two girls coming down here any minute.
You mean you told them to be here at 8?
I don't know, 7:38. What's the difference?
Tell you what the difference is. You told me you'd be home at 7, and you helped me with cocktails. They arrive at 7:30 and we have hors d'oeuvres. At 8 o'clock we have dinner. Well, it's 8 o'clock now. My meatloaf is finished. If we don't eat now, the whole damn thing will be dried out.
Oh, God, help me!
Never mind helping you! Tell him to save my meatloaf!
Can't you keep it warm?
What do you think I am? The magic chef? I'm lucky I got it to come out at 8. What am I supposed to do, boss, here?
Keep pouring gravy on it.
What gravy?
Don't you have any gravy?
Where the hell am I supposed to get gravy at 8 o'clock?
I don't know. I thought it comes when you cook the meat.
You don't know the first thing that you're talking about. You have to make gravy. It doesn't come.
Well, you asked my advice. I'm giving it to you.
You didn't know where the kitchen was until I came here and showed it to you.
You wouldn't talk to anybody, put down that spoon.
Spoon? You dumb ignoramus! It's a ladle! You don't even know a ladle when you see one!
Hey, Felix, get a grip on yourself, okay?
You think it's so easy? Go on! Go make me look for 4 people who show up a half an hour late!
My God, I'm arguing with him over gravy.
Well,
our dinner guests. They're here.
I'll get a saw and cut the meat.
There you are!
I'm not taking the blame for this, Oscar!
Who's blaming you? No one even cares about the dinner.
I care! I take pride in what I do. And you're gonna explain to them exactly what happened.
Fine, fine. You can take a Polaroid picture of me coming in at 8 o'clock, okay? Anything you want. But now take off that stupid apron, okay? I'm opening the door.
I just want to get one thing clear, Oscar. This is the last time I ever cook for you. Because it's people like you who don't even appreciate a decent meal.
You're the reason they have TV dinners.
Is it true?
I'm true.
Then smile.
Hello.
Oh, no, no, you timed it perfectly. Felix, I like it to be Felix. Felix, this is Gwendolyn, and this is Cecily.
Cecily and Gwendolyn.
Right, Cecily and Gwendolyn, and don't tell me, it's, Pigeon. Okay, then it's Cardinal.
Wrong both times, it's Pigeon.
Pigeon, right. Pigeon, yes, Cecily and Gwendolyn Pigeon. And Felix, I'd like to meet Felix. This is our chef of the night and my roommate.
How do you do?
How do you do? Wow, we did that beautifully, didn't we? Hey, how about we make ourselves more comfortable, huh? Hey.
This is never so nice, isn't it, Gwen?
Lovely, and much nicer than our flat. Do you want help?
Yes, I have a man who comes in every night.
Aren't you the lucky one?
Isn't this nice? You know, I was telling Felix the other day how he happened to meet.
Oh? Who's Felix?
Thank you.
Oscar tells me you're sisters.
Yes, that's right.
You're from England.
Yes, that's right.
I see. We're not brothers.
Yes, we know.
Although I am a brother. I have a brother. He lives in Buffalo. That's upstate New York.
Yes, we know.
You know my brother.
No, we know that Buffalo is upstate New York. We've been there. Have you?
No. Is it nice?
Lovely.
Well, that was certainly interesting. So, how long have you been in the United States of America?
Almost 4 years now.
You're just visiting, are you?
No, we live here.
And you work here too, do you?
Yes, we're secretaries for Cinderella. You know, the health club. People bring us their bodies and we do wonderful things with them. Actually, if you're interested, we can get you 10% off. 10% off the price. Now it's off your body.
Oscar!
What field of endeavor are you engaged in?
Oh, I write the news for CBS.
Oh, fascinating. Well, where'd you get your ideas from?
The news.
Oh. Maybe you can mention Gwendolyn in one of your news reports.
Well, maybe if you do something spectacular, I will.
Oh, we've done spectacular things, but I don't think we want to spread all over the telly. Do you, Gwendolyn?
It's such a large apartment, sometimes you have to shout.
Just you two batches live here?
Batches? Oh, you mean bachelor. We're not bachelors. We're divorced. That is, Oscar's divorced.
Well, we couldn't be these two, as they say. You couldn't have a better match for them, could you?
No, I suppose not.
Although, technically I'm a widow. My husband and I were getting a divorce, but he died before the final year.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry. Divorce is a terrible thing, isn't it?
Well, it can be if you haven't got the right solicitor. That's true. Sometimes they can drag it out for months. I was lucky. Nick caught and I was free.
It's terrible what it does to people. After all, what is divorce? It's taking two happy people and tearing their lives completely apart. That's kind of inhuman, isn't it?
Yes. That'd be an awful bother. Well, that's all water under the bridge now, eh? I'm awfully sorry, but I think I forgot your name.
Felix.
Oh, yes, of course, Felix. Like a cat. Well, the pigeons will have to beware of the cat, won't they?
That's the worst part about
it. Chocolate sweethearts, were you?
Oh, no, that's my little boy and girl. He's 7, she's 5.
Sweet. I imagine you must miss them terribly.
Oh, I can't stand being away from them.
That's what happens with the boys.
When do you get to see them?
Every night. I stop there on the way home from work. Then I get them on weekends and holidays in July and August.
Well then, when is it that you miss them?
Oh, whenever I'm not there. If they didn't have to get up so early in the morning, I'd go over and make them breakfast. They love my French toast.
You're certainly a devoted father.
No, it's Frances who's a wonderful.
She's the little girl.
Oh, no. She's the mother, my wife.
The one you're divorcing?
Mm-hmm. She's done such a beautiful job of raising them up. They're such nice kids. So polite. And she did it all. She's the type of woman who just always... Never mind, you don't want to hear any of this.
Nonsense. You have a right to be proud. You've got two beautiful children and a wonderful ex-wife.
That's her. That's Frances.
Oh, she's pretty, isn't she pretty, Cecily?
Oh, yes, pretty. A pretty girl, very pretty.
Here's another one.
But there's no one in that picture.
Oh, I know. That's my living room.
Oh. Those are lovely hats.
We got those lamps in Mexico on our honeymoon. I used to love to come home at night. That was my whole life. My wife, my kids, my apartment.
Does she have the lamps now too?
Yes, I gave her everything. It'll never be like that again. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to get emotional. Here, have some potato chips.
Oh, you mustn't be ashamed. I think it's a real quality in a man to be able
please,
to cry.
Please, you mustn't talk about it. You only made it worse.
I think it's sweet. Terribly sweet.
Oh, it's so refreshing to hear a man speak so highly of the woman he's forcing. Oh, dear. They have got me thinking about my poor Sydney.
Oh, Gwen, please don't.
It was a good marriage at first. Everyone said so, didn't they, Cecily? Not like you and George.
That's right. George and I were never happy. Not for one single solitary day.
That's ridiculous.
I don't know what happened. I was feeling something a few moments ago.
I had to cry because I was lonely.
Let it pour out. It'll make you feel better. I always do.
Oh, dear.
Is everybody happy? Oh, what the hell happened?
Nothing, Oscar, nothing.
I'm gone 3 seconds. I walked into a funeral parlor. What'd you say to them?
I didn't say anything. Don't start in on me again, Oscar.
You go for 5 minutes. If you really want to cry, go in there and look at your meatloaf.
Oh, my gosh, why didn't you call me? I told you to call me.
Hey, girls, I'm sorry, I forgot to warn you about Felix. I'm the walking soap opera.
Well, I think he's the dearest thing we ever met.
He's so sensitive, so fragile. I just went to bundle him up in my arms and take care of him.
I'm afraid when he comes out of that kitchen, you may have to. Not so bad. Let's take a look at it.
Here, look! Take all this and throw our sin for the ashes!
It can't be that bad. Maybe we can save some of it, huh?
There's nothing to save, Oscar! It's all black meat, and nobody likes black meat!
Well, can't I even take a look at it, huh? Let me see it.
No! Maybe if you were to look at your watch before, you wouldn't have to look at the black meat now!
Felix! Can we look at it?
Please. Oh, dear. How about Chinese food?
Hey, that's a great idea.
I've got another one. Why don't we make potluck in the kitchen?
Hey, that's an even better idea. Felix, what do you say?
Used up all my big pots.
Well, then, we can eat them at our place. We've got tons of corn and potters.
Well, that's the best idea I ever heard. How about it?
You'll have to take off your jackets. It's awfully hot up there.
Well, can't we just open the refrigerator?
Give us 5 minutes to get to our cooking things.
Well, can't you make it full? I'm suddenly starving to death.
And don't forget the wine.
No, I won't forget the wine.
And the corkscrew.
And the corkscrew.
And Felix.
No, I won't forget Felix.
Ta-ta!
Ta-ta!
Ta-ta! You bet your sweet little crumpets, ta-ta! Felix, I love ya! If you just overcooked this in the one hell of a night! And come on, let's get upstairs and get the ice bucket.
I'm not going.
What?
I said I'm not going.
Are you out of your mind? Hey, you know what's waiting for us up there? You've just been invited to spend the evening in a two-bedroom hothouse with the Cuckoo Pigeon Sisters! What do you mean you're not going?
I don't have anything to talk about, Oscar. I don't know what to say. I already told him about my brother in Buffalo. I used up all my conversation.
But Felix, they love you. They told me they love you. So one of them wants to wrap you up and make a bundle out of you. You're doing better than I am. Now come on, will you go in there and get the ice bucket?
But don't you understand, Oscar? I cried. I cried in front of two women.
And they loved it! Felix, I'm thinking of getting hysterical myself, okay? Now will you get the ice bucket?
But why, Oscar? Why did I cry? Because emotionally, I'm still tied to Francis and the kids.
Can't you untie the knot just for tonight, will ya?
I don't want to discuss it any further. We're gonna wash my hair and scrub the pots.
Those greasy pots and your greasy hair can wait! They're coming upstairs with me!
I'm not!
Felix, what am I supposed to do up here with two girls, huh? Don't do this to me, I'll never forgive you! You mean you're not going to make any effort to change? This is the person you're going to be until the day you die?
We are what we are, Alistair.
Thank you.
cleaning it up.
Is that a promise?
Did you hear what I said? I'm not cleaning that up. It's your mess. Just look at it there, hanging all over the wall.
I loved it.
You'd leave it there, wouldn't you? Till it turns brown and hard and it's disgusting. Well, I'm cleaning it up.
Hey, you leave that alone! You're not one straight level with Gwendolyn out on the right side of the
watch place. Yourself, Oscar! Watch yourself! I can take a couple tranquilizers!
Go to your room! Hear what I say, go to your room!
All right, let everybody settle down!
Wanna live through this night, Felix? You better tie me up, and you better lock all your doors and windows!
All right, Oscar. I'd like to know what happened.
What happened?
That's right, what happened?
Something must have made you go out the deep end like this. What was it? Something I said? Something I did? What?
It's nothing you said, it's nothing you did, it's you!
Well, that's plain enough.
I can make a plain appearance, but I don't want to hurt you.
What was it, Oscar? The cooking? The cleaning? The crime?
That's exactly what it is. It's the cooking, the cleaning, and the crying. It's the talking in your sleep. It's the moose calls. At 2 o'clock in the morning, they open up your ears. Can't take it anymore, Bill, so crack it up. Everything you do irritates me. And then everything I know you're going to do when you get in irritates me. Little notes on my pillow. Told you 100 times I can't stand little notes on my pillow. We're all out of cornflakes, F you. It took me 3 hours to figure out the F you was Felix Unger. It's not your fault, Felix. It's just a rotten combination.
All right, Oscar. I get the picture.
The picture, Felix? That was just the frame. The picture I haven't even painted yet. I've got a typewritten list in my office of the top 10 things you do to drive me berserk. Well, but last night was the topper, Felix. Last night was the topper. It was the ever-loving Lulu of all times.
What are you talking about, Oscar? The meatloaf?
No, not the meatloaf. Talking about those 2 lamb chops upstairs. Had it all set up, ready to go with that English Betty Boop and her sister. And I wind up drinking tea all night and telling your life story.
Oh, so that's what's wrong with you. I loused up your evening.
Well, after the mood you put them in, I'm surprised they didn't go out to Rockaway and swim back to England.
Well, don't blame me, Oscar. I warned you not to make the date in the first place.
Don't point that finger at me unless you intend to use it.
Get off my back, Oscar! Get off!
Oh, what is this, a display of temper? I don't think I ever see you really angry until the day I drop my cigar on your pancake back.
You're asking to hear something I don't want to say, Oscar. But if I say it, I think you'd better hear it.
You got anything on your chest besides your chin, you better get it off.
I warned you. You're a wonderful guy, Oscar. You've done everything for me. If it wasn't for you, I don't know what would have happened to me. You took me in here, gave me a place to live and something to live for. And I'll never forget you for that, Oscar. Never. You're tops with me.
I've just been told off, I think I may have missed.
No, it's coming now. You're also one of the biggest slots in the world. Completely unreliable, undeniable, and irresistible. Irresponsible.
Good, good. Keep going. That seems to be really hot now. Can you keep going? You got anything else to say?
No, that's it. You've been told.
Good. Now I'm going to tell you all. 6 months I lived alone in this apartment. I was despondent, dejected, and disgusted. And then you moved in. My dearest and closest friend in the world. And after 3 weeks of close personal contact, I'm about to have a nervous breakdown. Do me a favor, Felix. Move into the kitchen. Let me get pots, your pans, and your meat thermometers, okay? Your ladles. When you want to come out, just ring a little bell, and I'll go running into the bedroom, okay? I'm asking you nicely, Felix, as a friend. Get out of my way.
Walk on the paper, will you? The floors are wet. All right, Oscar. All right, settle down.
Come on, Felix, just give me one shot, huh? You bigot. Sinuses, kidneys, whatever. Come on.
On your hands, bud.
It's only 8 rooms, Felix. There's no place to hide. I know all the shortcuts.
Is this how you solve your problems, like an animal?
All right, fine. You want to see how I settle my problems? I'll show you. I want you to wrap all your stuff up in your saran wrap, pack it up, and get out!
You mean actually move out?
Actually, physically, and immediately. I don't care where you go. Move into the Museum of Natural History. I'm sure you'll be very happy there. You can dust around Egyptian mummies so your heart's content. But I'm a human living person, Felix. All I'm asking for is a little bit of freedom. Is that too much to ask for? Huh? There, you're all packed up.
You know, I've got a good mind to really leave.
Why doesn't he ever hear me? I know I'm talking, I recognize my voice.
Because if you want me to go, I'll go.
Then go! I want you to go, so go! Who's stopping you? When are you going?
Where am I going, huh? We're in a bigger hurry than Francis was.
Take as much time as she gave you. I want you to follow your usual routines.
So in other words, you're throwing me out.
No! Not in other words! Those are the perfect words! I am throwing you out!
All right. I just wanted to get the record straight. Let it be on your conscience.
What? What? Hey, let what be on my conscience?
Now you're throwing me out. I'm perfectly willing to stay and clear the airs of our differences, but you refuse, right?
Right, I'm sick and tired of you clearing the air, that's why I want you to leave.
As long as I heard the words, get out of my house. But remember, Oscar, what happens to me out there, it's your responsibility. Let it be on your head.
No, wait a minute, damn it. Why can't you be thrown out like a decent human being? Why do you gotta say things like, let it be on your head? I don't want it on my head. I just want you out of my house.
What's wrong, Oscar? Can't cope with the little guilt feelings?
Damn you! I've been looking forward to throwing you out all day, and I even take the pleasure out of that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me for spoiling your fun. I'll be leaving you, according to your wishes and desires.
Wait a minute. You're not going anywhere until you take it back.
Take what back?
Let it be on your head. What the hell is that, the curse of the cat people?
Get out of my way.
how you left that night with Francis. I'm surprised you wanted to have your room repainted. I'm going to have yours dipped in bronze.
How am I supposed to leave, Oscar, if you're blocking the door?
Hey, Felix, we've been friends a long time, okay? Now, for the sake of that friendship, just say, Oscar, we can't stand each other, let's break up.
I'll let you know what to do with my clothes. Either I'll call or somebody else.
Hey, where will you go?
Where? Well, come on, Oscar. You're not really interested, are you?
Come on, Felix, come back. We'll try and iron things out. Come on, you win! Don't leave me like this, you louse!
Oscar, just get a hold of yourself.
He's gone. Just keep telling you. He's gone. He's gone.
Yeah, but he did. He put that thing on your head. What the hell is that?
Hey, what's the matter with Felix? He didn't watch our fire, we were dead.
You even sacrificed the guy's face.
Yeah, where's he going, Oscar? I said, hey, Felix, where are you going? He said, only Oscar knows. Only Oscar knows. So where's he going?
How the hell should I know? Come on, just... get your chips, let's get the game started.
Alright, but I gotta get some meat first. I'm starving.
Any play tonight?
You guys smell spaghetti.
Any play tonight?
I don't want to discuss it, Vinnie. I don't even want to hear his name mentioned.
Who, Felix?
You're going to have to mention his name!
I didn't know what name you were talking about.
Did you know that there's spaghetti all over your kitchen?
Yes, Murray, I know there's spaghetti. But it's not spaghetti, it's linguine.
Oh.
Something wrong with Felix.
What?
With Felix, is something wrong?
Yeah, what's the matter with Felix?
Okay. It was my decision. I admit it. I threw him out of the house. Let it be on my head.
We'll go to pieces. I know, Felix. I'll try something crazy.
What's going to be on your head, Oscar?
How should I know? Felix put it there. Ask him. Okay, why do you think I did it, huh? Because I'm selfish? Because I just wanted to be cruel? No, I did it for you. I did it for you. I did it for all of us.
You've been drinking again? What are you talking about?
All right, okay. We've all been through his ashtrays and his napkins and his bacon, lettuce, and tomato sandwiches, but that was just the beginning. Just the beginning. Do you know what he had in mind for next Friday night poker game? As a change of pace, do you have any idea?
What am I, man?
A luau. A Hawaiian luau. Spare ribs, roast pork, and fried rice. They don't play poker like that in Honolulu.
Well, yeah, but one thing has nothing to do with the other. We all know he's completely impossible to live with these are for any cell on the street, and I'm still worried about it.
And I'm not! I'm not concerned! I'm not worried! Huh? What do you think sent him out there in the first place? What?
Francis sent him out in the first place. You sent him out in the second place. Francis sent him out in the third place. Don't you see? It's Felix. He does it for himself.
Why?
I don't know why. He doesn't know why. You know, last night, I was flipping through the TV, and I saw this naked woman. So needless to say, it caught my attention. It turned out to be this thing called the Discovery Channel, right? Yeah, and there was this documentary about this tribe in Africa that just go around hitting themselves on the head all day long.
I'm not going to worry about him. I'm not. See, he is not worrying about me. He's out there on the streets, crying and sulking and having a wonderful time. If he had a spark of human decency, he would leave us all alone and just go back to Blanche.
Why?
Blanche's wife.
No, Blanche is your wife. His wife is Francis.
Right, some kind of wise guy?
Then I say.
Okay, poker game's over. I don't want to play anymore.
Over? We didn't even start yet.
Is that all you can do is complain? Haven't you given one single thought to where Felix might be?
I thought you just said you weren't worried.
I'm not worried, David. I'm not worried. It's him. I bet it's him. No. He is not welcome in this. this house.
What are you talking about? Don't be childish. We gotta let him in.
No way! I'm not gonna give him satisfaction alone, know that we've been worrying about him. Now just sit down and play poker like nothing ever happened. Okay? Come on! Sit down! Play poker! Nothing ever happened, okay? Hey! Come on, Vinnie, open the door.
Okay. Oh! Hello.
It's not him, Oscar.
How do you do?
Don't! Hello, Cecily. Boys, I'd like you to meet Cecily Pigeon.
Gwendolyn Pigeon, please don't get up. May I have a moment with you, Mr. Madison?
Certainly, Gwendolyn. What's the matter?
I think you know. I've come for Felix's things.
Felix? My Felix?
Yes, Felix Unger. That sweet, tortured man is in my flat at this moment pouring his heart out to my sister.
You hear this? I'm worried to death that he's up there getting tea and sympathy.
Gwen, Felix is about to stay. Please tell him to stay.
Really, girls? This is very embarrassing. I can find a place of my own.
Nonsense. I told you we've plenty of room, and it's a very comfortable sofa. Isn't it, Cecily?
Enormous, and we've rented an air conditioner.
We just don't like the idea of you wandering the streets looking for a place to live.
Well, wouldn't I be in the way?
How could you possibly be in anyone's way?
You want to see a typewritten list?
Haven't you said enough already, Mr. Madison?
Just for a few days, Felix. Just until you can settle. Please say yes.
All right. Just for a few days.
Oh, wonderful, marvelous.
You get your things and come right up.
And come hungry. We're making dinner.
Good night, gentlemen. Sorry to interrupt your bridge game.
If you'd like, you can bring your friends to play on our flat.
And don't be late. Cocktails in 15 minutes.
Oh, I won't.
Ta-ta! Ta-ta!
Ta-ta!
Ta-ta! Ta-ta!
I told you it was always the quiet guys.
Gee, what nice girls. Hey, Felix, are we really going to move in with them?
Oh, just for a few days, until I can find my own place. Well, so long, fellas. You can drop your crumbs on the floor again.
Hey, Felix, wait a second. Aren't you going to thank me?
For what?
The two greatest things I ever did for you. Taking me in and throwing you out.
You're right, Oscar. Thanks a lot. Being thrown out twice is enough for any man. In gratitude, I remove the curse.
Oh, bless you and thank you, Wicked Witch of the North.
That must be the girls.
Well, they do hate it so when I'm late for cocktails.
It's your wife.
Well, do me a favor, Murray, and tell her I can't talk to her now. But tell her I'll be calling her in a few days, because we have a lot we need to chat about. And tell her if I sound different, it's because I'm not the same man she threw a few weeks ago.
Okay, well, when I see her, this is Oscar's wife. Hold on, wait,
Yeah, hello, Blanche.
So long, Phil.
Yeah, I got a pretty good idea why you're calling, and you got my check, right? No, I haven't been winning at the track. No, I've just been eating home a lot lately. Yeah. Well, it's nice of you, too. I'm just doing what's right. Now, listen, Blanche, did Brucey get the goldfish I sent him? Good. Well, all right, feel free. I mean, I don't go out much anymore.
Good night, Mr. Madison. If you need me again, I charge $6.50 an hour.
Hey, Blanche, I'll kiss him for me, okay? I gotta go. Bye. Hey, Felix, wait a second. What about next Friday? You're not gonna break up the poker game, right?
Me? Never. Marriages may come and go, but the game is still on. So long.
So long, Blanche! Wait, you gonna sit there? We're gonna play cards.
We're gonna play cards.
Okay, then let's play cards.
Fine.
And play.
please. Speedy, why don't you cigarette, why don't you stop? It's my house, not a pigsty.